There's this thing called electrical, and usually I say don't mess with electrical, that could mess you up. But today is an exception. I want to install an electrical box to my treehouse, right over here. So this treehouse used to be in my friend's backyard, just sitting there, wasted from years of neglect in the sun, deteriorating. His kids were no longer in that, yay, it's fun to be in a treehouse stage of their life. So I took it off his hands, brought it over here, rebuilt it, supersized it, added a swing, added a climbing post, a little balancing beam over here, as well as this amazing window. This window is from a craftsman style bungalow a few years back. The bungalow was scheduled for demolition. A sad piece of reality was about to happen. But I guess we need condos, right? So the bungalow got surrounded by some fencing. They dropped off the tractors the day before. And we were watching this sadness, me and Kevin. And later that night, after one too many Mountain Dews, we thought, you know what? I don't think the tractor driver is going to care if the bungalow is missing a window. Score. Welcome to the treehouse. And now the treehouse will also have an electrical box. And I think it will go right here. I like electrical boxes because you could use them as a storage box that's made out of metal. Very durable. What do we have here? My drill set. My art supplies. Fireworks. Look, a box full of doll heads. Now this thing is pretty ancient, but it is gonna do the trick. And it's so convenient. They come with holes already in it. Sweet. Now I think most people mounting an electrical box would have already had the wiring and the conduit and all that mounted on it first. But that's probably for people that are using it for electrical purposes. I'm using it as a box. And look, through the power of magic, look what's inside. You ever do repetitive training exercises in your backyard and forget what number you're on? Not me.